The Borno State Government has embarked on registration of all non-governmental organizations, NGOs, international non-governmental organizations and humanitarian aid agencies in a bid to improve on the coordination of their activities in the state. The Special Advisor and Coordinator of Sustainable Development Partnerships and Humanitarian Support Borno State, Mairo Mandera, in a high-level advocacy meeting organized by the Search for Common Ground in Abuja, says the registration is extremely critical as it will enable the state government know and to keep a tab on the activities of NGOs in the state. The special advisor says there is a need to ensure the security of humanitarian aid agencies as they embark on their activities.
The humanitarian and development supporters are really coming to help us, but the one thing that was missing for a long time is coordination. There is no coordination, everybody is doing their own thing. So what the government of Borno State has decided to do right now is to set up a coordination mechanism where everything will be transparent. Every NGO, INGO coming to Borno will register with us. We know what they've come to do, what they're doing, where, how, and how much they're bringing into the state, so that they're not they are not just only the ones accountable, but we are also accountable for how much is being spent on our people. But most importantly, I think we want to move to the next stage of encouraging development, encouraging people to take pieces of their lives. When people are given handouts day in, day out for 10 years, they lose that urge to be able to earn. So now we're encouraging people to earn and to have dignity.
We are 10 years down the crisis, and there are humanitarian needs on the ground, and there are about 2 million IDPs still in Borno State. But at the same time, there are developmental needs which cannot be compromised for the sake of it. So, and with all that, I think we are here with the invitation of the Nigerian government. So how all the actors, the humanitarian development piece, can work better together with the Nigerian government to achieve a lasting change, a positive change for the communities on ground.
A lot of times the humanitarian interventions are providing incredibly critical and important life-saving support, but it is creating tensions within the communities. Who gets the support? Who doesn't get the support? IDPs are getting humanitarian support, but host communities aren't, because they, you know, the assumption being that they live in the community, but they're still very much affected by lack of livelihood opportunities, lack of access to their, you know, to their fields, to their agriculture. So all of these come up. These tensions, this lack of coordination, this lack of collaboration, mistrust between the different actors, and this need to, you know, to approach it together.